good to know. People come and go.
All right, here. You ready to start the show? I'm ready to start the show. Let me get this out of here, and we'll get ready to start the show. I'm ready. Here we go. Let's start it. Let's light this candle.
Calling all stations. Clear the air lanes. Clear all air lanes for the big broadcast.
Good to know, people come and go.
All right, welcome to this week's edition of the Wednesday Drive, brought to you in part by our good friends down at the Milo Locker in Milo, Iowa. It's almost deer season. They'll be hopping here pretty quick. We got a fun show for you this week. We're going to be talking trail cams and filming hunts with Tactacam and Tactacam Reveals. I've got Ben Stein lined up to do the show with me. Ben's one of the designers, engineers. And if you are a trail cam fanatic as much as I am, you should enjoy this program. Let me go ahead and get Ben on the line here. And hello, everybody on Facebook Live. Thank you for checking in on Facebook. We appreciate you. Let me get Ben on the line right now, and we'll get him. Okay, there we go. We'll get him going. I love the ringy dingies.
Hello.
Ben, it's Outdoors Dan. You're live on the Wednesday Drive. How are you today?
Not too bad. Not too bad.
Hey, can you believe we're almost in September, buddy?
I know. I was just out putting a couple new cameras out and saw some deer and got excited. I'm like, oh, boy, not too much further.
Yeah, you guys are always putting out stuff, man. You, Jeff, and everybody over there, I tell you, that's exciting. Hey, Richard. Hey, Tony. Thanks for checking out the show on Facebook Live. We appreciate you. Yeah. Hey, you're an engineer. Let me ask you this. So I've been doing these live streams on Facebook with Ecamm. Ecamm's the software that I use. So I've been using this on my Facebook profile for like a year and a half. Okay? They did an update. Ecamm did. And now I have to go to the Outdoor Call Radio app page on Facebook to do the so people can message me in real time and I can see it. They could see the broadcast and stuff on my profile. I've sent Ecamms, I don't know, like 30,000 emails and messages and stuff, and sent them reports and all that other stuff. But how did that glitch, Ben?
Interesting. Sounds like they did. Sounds like they did some firmware updates or something. And guess what?
Yeah. Well, it's annoying. I mean, it's just I love, you know, because I like Ecamm. I mean, it's easy for me to see the folks, and if they got a question or if they want to say hi, they can message me in real time and stuff, which is nice. But it's just yeah, it's annoying. You engineer guys, you're killing us high school grads, man. Come on.
Well, that's not the goal, just so you know.
Hey, I got cameras out. Larry and Ryan came up last week, and we did a farm day. And we got a bunch of cameras and stuff out. Man, I made sure I went and did my X-Pros and got all the firmware updates. Thank you guys for getting that info out on the Tactacam social media side and reaching out to partners like me to let everybody know to go in there and throw an SD card in your computer and just download those firmware updates. And then once you get them in the SD card, you just load them into your camera and bada bing, bada boom, it's all updated and you're ready to go for the fields. Easy.
Yeah, it is. It's super easy update, and there's a lot of benefits to it. You know, I mean, image resolution, just better quality. That's just the start, but there's a bunch of stuff happening in the back end that just makes it even faster and a higher performing camera. So yep. It's worth the update.
So since I've got you on for 25 minutes, I get a lot of questions, as you can imagine, throughout the year about trigger speeds, fog, condensation. Is this an entity or a ghost that's showing up on my trail camera? I mean, what is this? So can we kind of, instead of covering the product, because I know we can touch all that later, but I want to get into the nuts and bolts of a camera. I've been with you guys since you popped the first camera out. Just a tremendous product, okay? Easy, super friendly, user-friendly. If I can figure it out, folks, you can figure it out, I promise you, because it's Outdoors Dan-proof. But what causes, going back to any camera, Ben, because it happens to, it's just not Tactacam, it happens to all the cameras. Condensation. How do you? Is there a way to get around that, or is that just part of it, having them out there on those high humidity or those weather related days?
The biggest thing is, like when you're changing batteries or doing anything like that, make sure you're not, in like a sprinkle will do it. Like it doesn't take much.
Okay.
Any little bit of moisture that gets inside that camera could cause that. I'm pretty cautious, I guess, but I don't really have that problem.
Okay.
But I also make sure, like, just checking my seals, making sure that I'm not getting, like, crap and whatever in there.
All right. So if you're using a solar panel, which I highly recommend everybody go get a Tactacam solar panel, because they just awesome. They're awesome. You can charge your batteries up or use a lithium pack. And then plug in that solar charger that you charge overnight, and then you take that out there. I'm seeing 6-7 months use out of this. I mean, it's crazy good. So you don't have you don't have to go in there and have the expense of changing out batteries and stuff all the time. But
exactly.
Okay, so when you set these up, I always try to set my cameras up as much as I can to the north, so I'm getting as much east and west sun as I can for those solar panels. Is there another trick to help reduce some of the condensation or moisture?
I think that's really the biggest trick, is just making sure that you, you're not getting moisture inside the cameras.
Okay.
And the seals.
Okay.
When you are changing batteries, making sure you're not, out there during a little bit of a sprinkle or something. So, I know a lot of people like to do that because it keeps the scent down.
Well, I'm talking about, most of this stuff is like when there's a heavy dew, when there's a lot of moisture, when the dew point's so high. That's where I start getting a lot of the questions. And again, it's not camera related, Ben, because it's going to happen no matter what camera manufacturer you use. I'm talking about, what are some good tips as far as, heavy dew points and stuff where we can keep that camera clear?
Yeah, basically, I guess for that type of stuff, I just try to keep the camera's angle down just a little bit.
Okay.
Keep stuff from, that just takes a little bit, slightly. We actually built the front end of that camera out a little bit just to kind of help with it.
Yeah.
In general, but whenever you have a lot of humidity in the air, it's going to stick to stuff.
Yeah,
that's what I think you're referring to. About something totally different.
I probably didn't explain myself. That's my fault. It wasn't camera related, because I'll be honest with you, I've never had a problem with the seals or anything on the Tactacams at all. I mean,
don't either. But the people that do, that's typically what happens is. Because I've done it. I go out and do it. I change batteries in the rain just to see what happens. And sure enough, you get water inside your camera.
Yeah,
it's gonna happen.
Yeah, you don't want that. That's for sure. So
no.
Now, all right. So and hey, am I right about having that camera pointed north as much as possible? Because that sun's going to burn off that dew faster than anything. As that sun rises, that energy is going to burn all that condensation off.
Yeah, so I typically try to not. I try not to point my cameras towards the sun at all.
Yeah,
but
I'm not saying I'm saying pointed north, because that way you're getting the most east and west sunlight exposure. Does that make sense?
Yeah, help with like your false triggers and all of that stuff.
Yeah,
you're just going to get better overall photos.
Absolutely, and I think a lot of people put their cameras too high. I like putting my camera lower. Because I want to be able to get that, I want to get down to that deer's level as much as possible. And you don't want that camera pointed up at all. Hey, Corey, what's going on, buddy? Good to see you. You want that camera pointed straight or down, slightly downward. But I try to keep that camera as low as I can, like three, four feet off the ground. I just want to get that, I want that point of view.
Yeah, and I would say most of mine are probably waist level.
Yeah.
And there's some that I actually will put even lower on the ground. Like some of my favorite pictures are, like maybe a foot and a half off the ground, and I just kind of get it shooting straight out into a field.
Yeah.
Especially if there's some contour to the field.
Yeah.
You're not going to be aiming at their angles. Like if they're down lower and or kind of moving through a little bit of terrain, you can get some really awesome photos, and it's just, I don't know, it's just a very cool perspective.
Okay. What?
Maybe not for everyone, but
oh, that's all right.
Some of my favorite photos.
Well, no, listen, you guys take some good shots, man. And I love it when you guys do the Tactacam picture contests and stuff. That's always a lot of fun, too.
So. It's always fun watching the photos that come in. I actually was just getting text messages right before this call, and this guy's got this awesome buck, like a really, really big buck.
Yeah.
And he's got like a tree, like in his antlers, like
a tree, like, tree.
Like a tree. Like he's walking around, and it's just like this giant, like
that's a big tree. Deer. That's a big deer, Ben.
Yeah. It's so funny though, like because it, you know, it looks like he just ripped his branch off, and he just like comes walking by the camera.
Oh, that's
and
funny.
It's on video, so. It was pretty good.
Yeah, that's
I should send it to you.
Yes, right, yes, send it to me. I want to see that. That's awesome. So what are these anomalies that you get? And I get them once in a while that look like a, they look like a lightsaber, like a 4 or 5 long light stream, or like a, I don't know, like a mist, or a,
those are.
What,
those are satellites flying over.
I don't know what they are. I got a couple the other night. It's just like there's like just like this little short streak of light, you know, flying, and I'm going, is that a bat? Is that a bat where the IR hits the bat, the wings and stuff, and it just looks like a streak of light, or is it a big bug? What are those things?
I think they're like just bugs, and
okay.
They're so close to the lens,
yeah.
They just look so weird, and it's really hard to get a perspective on them because it's nighttime. They're, you know, getting lit up from the LEDs, you
yeah.
know, just for that exposure that's happening, you know, 30 feet, 40 feet, or 20 feet, however far away it's set up. And then all of a sudden you got this bug that's like flying through really close to the lens, and it just looks so weird.
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of spooky. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's all right. I'm sure you get a lot of this. I don't think I've ever asked you this stuff on the air before. So,
this is fun.
I told everybody I was going to get you some different questions tonight. As we get into cold weather, are you better off going with the lithium packs or with the lithium batteries? What's going to and when you get down to 15, 20 degree weather, what's going to get you the longest duration in the field?
So you're going to want to use either a lithium, like a AA lithium battery,
okay,
or one of our rechargeable lithium packs.
If you had to choose between the two, what would you choose, the pack or the batteries?
I would use the pack only because I can recharge that. I buy a couple extra,
yeah,
and I keep them charged. If I need to go change one, I just go in and swap it out, and then I charge the one I took out, so I'm not buying any batteries anymore.
Okay, here's another question I want to throw at you. I had somebody ask me, they just bought 2 year solar panels, they love them, and he didn't tell me which camera he was going to, I wish I would have known that, but he said he wanted to know, can you put the solar panel up and plug that into your camera without having batteries and have it run okay?
You can.
Okay.
The downfall with that is, the batteries act as a backup.
Okay.
So like if for some reason the solar panel is not getting enough sun or it dies, like just from lack of sun, the batteries start to kick in, and then that's how you know, like, oh, something happened to my solar panel, or it's not getting enough sun, so you go fix it.
Okay. Now I don't know this from my own knowledge, so I'm going to ask you: a fully charged solar pack, how long? Tactacam solar panel, how long is that good for battery life?
So if you flip it upside down, you get like 6,000 photos getting any sun.
Really?
Yeah.
6,000?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's awesome, man. That's way better than I thought it would be. Okay.
Yep.
All right.
So it's pretty solid.
No.
And then when you add the sun to it and you start, you know, charging the battery back up while you're using it, I've got some, like I think I've told you on the show, I've got cameras that have been out for at this point over 2 years.
Yeah, and they're still running.
You know, like, and they still run. Yeah, they're just running.
Yeah, that's awesome. Well, you know, and you know which one of my favorite cameras is, don't you? I love the SK. The SK's got the solar panel built into it. That is that's a great camera, Ben.
The SK.
That with the dual antenna, that I get better that I have yet to be able to get signal and have that not run good with that SK model. That camera knocks it out of the park.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, all of our cameras get incredible cell service, but the SK with the module we use, the dual antennas, it somehow does a little bit better. But honestly, I don't have too many spots that I would need to run SK onlys. But it is nice to have that camera in the backpack. And if for some reason I come across the trail and I'm like, wow, this is down in a holler, and you know, I can throw that camera up and it's usually going to connect.
Yeah. No, that's exciting. All right. I got it. Ben, hold it. Can you hold for me? I got to take a real quick break. I want to pay some bills.
Absolutely.
And then when we come back, I'm going to flip it on the Tactacam side from the reveal. I got some 6.0 and some other questions for you. Is that okay?
Let's hear it.
Okay. And folks, listen, if you want to ask Ben a question, just message me the question on Facebook on the live stream here. Just if you got a question, I'll ask him when we come back. I'll be right back. Ben, hang on. It'll be about 2 minutes.
Okay, sounds good.
All right, that's Ben. Let me go to this.
In these times when a lot of us are working from home, it's even more important to make sure your home is the right temperature and comfortable. Now is a great time to call the experts at Wyckoff Heating and Cooling at 287-6000 to schedule a check on your current heating and cooling systems. Is your house too dry and giving your family issues? A Honeywell dehumidifier system installed with your AC heating system can solve that issue right away. Wyckoff Heating and Cooling is a family-owned and operated business that has been serving Iowa residents and businesses for over 70 years. They offer 24-hour service and programs like the Peace of Mind Plan for less than $15 a month. So if you want more time on the water or in the woods this year, please call the folks at Wyckoff Heating and Cooling for any of your home or business heating and cooling needs. One call to Wyckoff Heating and Cooling will bring you peace of mind under your roof every day.
Hey, students, are you into shooting sports? Well, if you are, have you ever thought about using your passion to help you through college? Grandview University is a small private college that is looking for students that have a passion for the shooting sports and learning. Grandview University has a shooting sports program that, if you qualify, will give you a guaranteed rate for your whole education while on the shooting team. That means your cost won't go up. You will get to experience a new level of competition and learn in a small class size with the feel of a larger campus with a ton of opportunities. So if you're looking to advance your education and love to shoot, why not shoot for a college program that has produced countless All-Americans and has a winning record of 4 times national champion? Grandview Shooting Sports athletes will have your ammo, uniforms, travel, and education covered in your scholarship. If you like to shoot for the stars and push yourself,
who's got questions? Now's the time to ask them.
For more information, check them out at gvvikings.com.
We all want the deadliest broadheads out there.
And you're talking right to one of the main engineers at Tactacam. What a great time to ask your question.
On the market. No matter which Slick Trick model you choose, the Raptor Trick, the Viper Trick, the Magnum, the Wicked Trick, the Grizz Trick 2, or the standard Slick Trick, they all offer bone-crushing penetration with superior
cutting diameter. Howdy, Hank. I'll be down there in the next couple days, bud.
Feral Alcatraz Blade Lock System to prevent broadhead failures at the moment of impact that will help you get your game. If you're a mechanical fan, the Raptor Trick is going to be your
favorite. I'm not going to ask him that on air, Richard. I'll see what I can do about that, okay?
And deadly accurate flight.
I don't want to put him under the gun, buddy.
100% of the time. You wait all season for that shot. Do not trust it to a head that will not deliver a short recovery. For more information, go online at slicktrick.net. This year, trick 'em with Slick Trick broadheads and tag your game.
Vanes are very important to your arrow flight and for consistent grouping. Flex Fletch and its fine lineup of products has been helping archers steer their arrows for over 50 years. Silent Night vanes are 30% thinner with a much greater taper than vanes out there. This contributes to a dramatic reduction of in-flight drag. Flex Fletch Vanes also have the capability of reshaping or bounce back, after pass-through shots on targets or game. This ensures consistent arrow flight every time. Flex Fletch offers a variety of colors, sizes, and styles for any archer to use in their setup. Whether it's for 3D indoor or hunting, Flex Fletch has the vane for you. To see these great vanes and adhesives like Zing or Flex Bond to get a great seal on your arrow when you fletch, go to your local dealer or flexfletch.com. Flex Fletch, proudly made in the USA, based out of Minnesota.
It's good to know people come and go.
All right, welcome back to the Wednesday Drive on the Outdoor Call Radio Network. My guest is Ben from Tactacam and Tactacam Reveal. We're talking a little cameras tonight here on the show. Ben, you still there? I didn't lose you, did I?
Nope, I'm here.
All right, you're good. All right, so let's talk a little bit about filming. I'm sure I've got some folks. I did have a guy ask me a question, but I'll ask you later because I'm not going to do that to you on the air. So he's trying to get a discount. So I said, you know, I'll approach that later. But you got, hey, Richard, I know what I can tell you. They've got a big bundle sale going on right now at a big discount, don't you, Ben?
There's actually a lot of discounts going on right now.
Go to.
I don't even know why, because everything's selling out. Like, I would say if you want some cameras, you better go get them, because they are flying.
RevealTacticam.com, or just look up Reveal Tacticam, Google it, and you'll find they got them right on their homepage, Richard. There you go. Big discount for you. So if someone's going to start taping their hunts, whether they're a crossbow hunter, a bow hunter, a gun hunter, you know, give me a couple quick suggestions on good setup techniques for trying to get the best footage you can with the units. Can you do that real quick?
Absolutely. So, I mean, to start out, like, either the Solo Extreme or the 6.0, either one of those cameras, they're both awesome. Like, I love using both of them, and I actually do use both of them. So either one, just depends on what type of money you want to spend.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to do the exact same thing. They're going to film and do it easily and allow you to capture your hunt. If you're looking, you know, for that full 4K, like super HD, like extra zoom, all the bells and whistles, that's when you want to jump into the 6.0. It is a lot higher end camera, but like I said, both of them are going to do the job. Just, you know, depends on what type of stuff you like, right?
What's the preferred distance on those cameras to get good footage, Ben? So can give them, you have a minimum or best range suggestion, 15, 20 yards?
Yeah, I mean, 15, 20 yards is ideal, like it's perfect, but I mean, I've shot stuff out 40, 50 yards and it still looks really good.
Okay.
You know, you'd be surprised, because the lens is not like a super wide lens. It's more of like a natural, like, miniature eye.
Mm-hmm.
So because of that, when you get that video back, you're like, dang, you know, like, that was a 40 yard shot, and it looks like I was right there. You know, and that's what makes Tactacam work so well, is that lens design and how it, you know, how it handles distance, but also it works, you know, at 10 yards.
Okay, I had a gentleman, his name is Wesley, and he's from Illinois. Wesley wanted to know I don't use a stabilizer. What is the best way to get a Tactacam on my bow where it's going to look decent when during and after the shot?
So I will mount them right onto the riser.
Okay. Like,
if, you know, so I actually use a stabilizer, but I like to mount the camera right on the riser, right up close to the pin, like my sight pin.
Uh-huh.
Typically on the right, like I'm a right-handed shooter, so it'd be like on the right-hand side of the bow, you know, so I film right down my sight. When I'm in a ground blind, it just works super, super nice, and to be honest with you, I just use some zip ties.
Yeah, no, we've talked about that in the past. I've done the same thing.
Yeah. You know, we've got plenty of mounts. Like, we got quarter 20 mounts, like adapters and stuff like that. But I like to just get that thing really close, right next to the to the riser, so I keep everything really nice and in line, and I just zip tie it right on there. And to be honest with you, it works really, really well.
Yeah. Hey, Bruce, good evening. Thank you for watching on the live stream on Facebook tonight. We appreciate that. Thank you. Hey, the audio on those cameras are amazing. Any audio tips for the folks?
So if you are in a bunch of wind, like, they will pick up wind, unfortunately. I mean, it's a microphone.
Yeah.
But what I do is I take, like, just a little piece of, like, felt. You know, like, you can get the ones that you put on the bottom of chairs and stuff. Those are bigger, but just a small, tiny piece. You can put that, like, right over the microphone hole, which is on the bottom, and it will knock that wind down. It's actually pretty impressive. We should probably sell those. But
so, like, a little, like a stick-on windsock.
Yeah, basically. That's all it is.
Yeah, and you're not seeing any loss of volume or anything out of the recording?
It will cut it down a little bit, but to be honest with you, it's better than hearing the wind.
Yeah, you're going to... Your audio is going to be better.
I only do that if it's, like, super windy, and half the time I'm not even hunting when it's windy like that. So it's just some rare occasions, you know, like, where you're out there. Maybe you're just out there filming, and, you know, you're going to be in a lot of wind.
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm getting a call. I had to cancel that.
No, you're good.
I was getting a bunch of wind, and, you know.
Was that?
Yeah.
So, you sure that wasn't me? I was blowing my grunt call at you.
Oh, I think it was your grunt call, but
I had my Woodhaven Intimidator on.
That's funny.
Yeah, I was going to give you a set you up for a grunt call question. So, you know what, folks? I learned something because I've been working with Ben and Tactacam for several years now, and I did not know to put that adhesive, the little felt on there. I'm going to start doing that. On all my cameras, whether I'm using a ground stake or on my bow. So thanks for the tip, Ben, because I appreciate that. Because it's all, hey, Ben. Ben thought that was hilarious. It's always windy, either in Iowa or Kansas. I mean, we've always got a lot of wind. So thank you for telling me that. And Wesley, I hope that helped you, Wesley. So there you go. Thanks for Wesley in Illinois doing that. All right, man. I'm not gonna keep you because I know you got an appointment. You got to go, but I can't tell you enough. Thank you so much for the partnership. We've got another camera or two to give away before the Christmas is here, and I'm excited about that. We've already given out a few, and everybody that's won them just enjoyed them. I enjoy them. We're running them on Respect the Game TV this year. I did not know if you knew that or not. But
awesome.
Yeah, we went out and put I think we put 15 cameras out the other day. Question for Ben, how can we join the Tactacam team? Ben Sam wants to know that, Ben.
Okay, so let me see. I got to get an email. I think the best way to do it would be, let me see here. Just shoot an email to support@tactacam.com and just say, I want to be on the Tacta team. I heard Ben on a podcast, and he said, send it here and make sure you get me to the right place.
Yeah.
You can write whatever you want, but something like that.
What's the email again, Ben?
Support@tactacam.com.
Support@tactacam.com. Tell them that you heard Ben on the Outdoors Dan Show, not some podcast. I'm gonna whop you. I'm gonna whop you, boy. Yeah. That's all right. I'll get you back, man. Tell him you heard him with Outdoors Dan, and Ben's a good guy. He'll help you. So
yeah, and if you do go to the tacticam.com page, mm-hmm. and you go to contact, there's a tab that comes down and it says team application. That's the application that you normally fill out.
Okay. When's your first hunt?
My first hunt?
Yeah.
I've already been on a few. I feel bad for saying that.
On your whitetails?
Whitetails is gonna be. I'm gonna go to see Dean Partridge up in Canada.
Oh wow!
And I'm gonna do Canadian whitetail.
You just got back, weren't you bear hunting?
Yeah. So we did a spring bear hunt.
Yeah.
I don't know how I pulled this off. I had some friends going to New Zealand. I went out there and did a stag and a tar.
Oh, good for you.
An amazing experience.
Yeah.
I would recommend anybody, save your money, go do it. It was awesome. And then I ended up doing an antelope last week.
Yeah, I saw you got a
Montana. Yeah,
I saw you got a goat. I was proud of you. So
I will tell everybody, I normally don't get to hunt like this. This is very rare, but I had a bunch of stuff get canceled and things get moved around and everything's like piled in this year. Don't feel bad for me because I'm loving it.
Yeah,
he's freaking awesome.
He's like the mad professor at Tactacam and Reveal, so they don't let him out very often. All right, buddy. Thanks for hopping on here on a weekday for me. Anything you want to tell the folks before I let you go?
Hey, thank you. You know, from day one when I started this company, it's been just something for fun, and it's amazing to see how this company has grown. And I love the fact that everybody out there is just as passionate about this as I am and using the product. And thank you for the support.
We love it, man. Good stuff. Thank you for making some good products that help us get our deer. So thank you.
Awesome.
All right,
we'll chat with you later.
Hey, we'll talk to you soon. Let me know if you need something.
Bye, thank you.
There he goes. There goes Ben. Alrighty. Hey, before we go, I am going to tell you real quickly. A lot of folks are asking about broadhead tuning right now. If you got an elite bow, you don't have to worry about that. You can just use the set technology. The set technology, if you don't know what that is, on an elite riser on the flagship bows, there's actually two little settings in the riser that will take your limb pocket and it will move it from side to side. So you don't have to shim your cams anymore to achieve perfect center shot or to get your bow perfectly tuned. You can just use that SEC technology with that limb rocket pocket and rocker, and it will achieve perfect tune. And then when you get ready to go from field tips to broadheads, a lot of folks will just move their sights. You don't want to do that. You really don't want to mess your tune up. You don't want to move your sight, your arrow rest in or out. A lot of folks used to take the poundage up and down. What you're trying to do is when you put a broadhead on your arrow, that usually will change your spine on your arrow shaft. So that's what you're trying to correct. So if you don't have an elite and don't have set technology, instead of chasing it with your pins on your sight bracket, try adjusting your poundage up a couple of turn or turn and a half on both sides of the bow and see if that brings those pins, that field point and that broadhead point of impact together. Try doing that. If you try to do it with your rest in and out, or if you try to do it with your sight pins, it can actually make things worse. So try the poundage first. And again, you can always take it to your local bow shop like Archery Field and Sports in Altoona, Iowa, or wherever you like to hang your bow, and they will help you out. But if you got an elite, that SEC technology is a game changer. I can actually take that and just turn it one quarter turn on the top of the bow and on the bottom of the bow, and within one shot, my broadheads will hit right where my field points go. And my distance, my group type, I can't talk tonight, guys. I apologize. My group type is amazing. I've never shot tighter groups with fixed broadheads in my life. Out to 30, 40, 50 yards. I'm not going out west now, so I'll be shooting 25 and in the Midwest. That's my comfort level on whitetails. But, man, I tell you what, it's just a game changer. So, anyway, I wanted to get that out there. Onyx has got a bunch of stuff coming up. If you have not been on Onyx, go check it out. They've got some new features coming out that's going to help you target your shooter bucks. Your target bucks, Onyx is going to help you get a leg up on them, so to say. Go check out Onyx, and you'll see what I'm talking about. And let's see, tonight, Unknown Files, I'll be on at 7 o'clock. I'll be right back here on Facebook Live on the live stream on the Outdoor Call Radio app page and on the network, too. So we're going East Coast ghost hunting. I'm hoping. I haven't heard from my guest, so I'm hoping she's not. We had to reschedule her. She wasn't feeling good. I'm hoping we don't. But even if I don't hear from her, I'll pop on, and we'll talk a little Unknown File. I'll tell you what's one of the shows coming up at the very least, okay? All right, I'm going to get out of here. Let me say goodbye to my Facebook audience first. And I will tell you, don't forget to be watching or listening to the Outdoor Call Radio app Monday through Friday. Send me a screenshot because we're going to start doing those fall hunting packs here soon, okay? So make sure you're listening Monday through Friday. We got a new show coming up next week, Onyx Media. That is going to be on, when did I tell? I think they're going to be on Thursdays. That's Jesse and the gang. That's going to be a fun show for you to listen to. And we had a few changes on the lineup too. So you'll see that starting next week. I'm going to say goodbye for a little bit on Facebook. I'll see y'all later. Thanks.